And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the blue corner, all the way from Termolin in Italy, it's Ivano Sibiero! Please welcome to the red corner, one of London's most entertaining fighters. It's the Pitbull, Jose Varela! And gentlemen, this A-class Muay Thai rules bout will take place in the minus 59 kilogram division over 5 3-minute rounds. Introducing to you firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, our visitor from Termolin in Italy, representing Team Capurso, please welcome Ivano Sibiero! And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, he's representing Team Jiu Gym in Central London, England. Go crazy for the Pitbull, Jose Varela!
Okay, fighters in the ring. Now, guys. Okay, no rules, you're fine under full Muay Thai rules. You both understand the rules. Then of a knockdown, you must go to the neutral corner. I will not begin to count and do so. That's guys, gentlemen. That's your corners.
Okay, fight number 15. It's the third count on the main card. Simon Benedettini versus Jose Varela from Team Chu.
I've seen Jose fight before and he is an absolute beast.
Yeah, he's very, very aggressive, very skillful.
You know what, I don't even think this will go the full five rounds. I really don't. I don't know who will win, but I don't think it will go five rounds.
Well, that's the world champion prediction. And Missy Mambalo.
Just started off so explosive.
Yeah, Jose there taking great, great control in the clinch, turning his man, trying with the continuous movement, shot on the way to the floor. Big right long knee then.
Hear that body kick.
Slamming in really hard, slapping the back of the Italian fighter.
Good teep, sir. Nice catch of the teep and a bit of a dump.
Valera is really comfortable in there. He's, you know, he's holding his position so well. He's not worried about what the Italian guy's doing at all.
It's when he catches that leg, he's just totally in control.
Yeah, I totally agree. He Benintini seems to be really, really out of his. He seems quite. He's panic fighting, for want of a better word. He's so hasty to try and land a shot.
Yeah,
he's probably going to walk onto him where Jose's just. It looks like he's at home.
Yeah, he's just like chilled standing out. His ground, isn't he?
Yeah, he's not bothered. That's all.
Oh!
Skimmed off the arm that.
That landed on his neck. Oh, them body shots must hurt.
So skillful in the clinch. Just making it so easy to off-balance his opponent.
I love that footwork in the clinch. Kind of twisting him round. I think he's going for that body shot.
Good catch and counter kick there. Again, turning and tripping. Massive score, biggest loss of position ever fallen on the floor.
That's it. And when he catches that leg, it's beautiful. Just takes him straight out.
He's so relaxed, just so at home. It's like nothing's fazed him at all.
I think that's a good first round.
Yeah, brilliant first round, but it's completely one-sided. If you were in the Italian corner, what would you be telling him to do right now?
It's quite hard, actually. I wouldn't tell him to body kick because he doesn't kick fast enough and Jose keeps catching it. So I'd tell him to 1-2 low kick and just move.
Yeah, I'm on the same page. He needs to strike and move.
Yeah.
They say the body kick's not quick enough. Jose is catching it so easily. On the same score, he needs to stay out in the clinch. When Jose steps in to clinch him, he needs to move back and then counter strike. Jose's so balanced. And he's just not bothered about him coming forward. He'll stand there all day and say, walk to me.
Yeah, I'm just worried if he gets too confident that he'll drop his hands. And I've seen him get knocked out before, and it worked nice. And I like the guy, so I just want him to keep his hands up.
Well, yeah, there's always that.
Round two.
Great left hook there.
Yeah.
Get a little telling off there.
Yeah, it was being warm for holding the ropes while striking.
I think Benintini looks worried, really. He's just kind of rushing forward.
He's panic fighting for me the whole way through. And he looks, for an orthodox fighter, he's so uncomfortable throwing his right leg. It's really strange because he doesn't throw with a... There's no fluidity in it at all.
Yeah, I don't think he looks that flexible either.
No.
Looks like he's going to fall over every time he kicks.
Like I say, it's like he's nervy and it's like panic fighting.
I think you can kind of see that on his face as well. Nice little elbow there by him.
Yeah, try to turn it in. But Valera's arms there, so, you know, stopping it. Jose then throwing a right elbow over the top himself. Nice teep.
Oh, he just looks so strong, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Oh, good right hand.
Yeah, straight on the button.
And he's still just calm, relaxed.
Just another day at the office, for all intents and purposes.
Look at that footwork. Amazing.
Tripped him, struck again on the way to the floor. I want a warning for that. I think that was a perfectly legal move.
Yeah, it was kind of a all-in-one, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's one continuous movement. Talent corner there, want the karangarang off the arm.
Or is that a tactic to give him advice?
Yeah, more than likely. Probably to give him a breather as well.
Yeah. But again, just catching and sweeping. And yeah, every time Benetti gets off the floor, you know, it's tiring getting up off that canvas all the time.
It's very tiring.
Again.
And I mean, Blair, you know, so effortless. So effortless. Nice spinning elbow there by Jose.
Look at that footwork and an elbow on top of the head. I think he got told off that one.
Again, I still want to work. I think it was a perfectly legal move. He turned him as he was forward, he threw a knee and an elbow. When it's all in one, it's very difficult to, you know. Nice, strong body kick, big right hand then.
He's relentless. I think he's looking to stop it, you know, Jose. Look, there's bad blood there.
Oh, that's what we like, that's what we like. Let's turn the heat up.
God.
Round three in this full-time rules competition, England versus Italy. Oh, big left uppercut then from Valera. Just drops Benitti onto the ropes.
He's loving it, isn't he? He's a showman.
He's a showman. He's so calm. He's so collected. On the floor again. Here we go.
And do you know what? Part of being a fighter is to put on a show for the crowd.
Of course it's.
The Italian guy's got a bit of a bloody nose.
He just took a really big left uppercut on that rope. Nice long knee.
Good job he had his hands up there for that high kick.
Valera's just got bad intention wrote all across his face, hasn't he? Yeah. Everything he throws has got a bad intention at the end of it.
He does look a little bit mean.
Yeah, he does.
I think he's waiting for it. He's waiting for the right moment and the right shot. The footwork again. Amazing. Kind of just walking through everything the Italian gives him.
The Italian for me is still panic fighting. He's dead twitchy. He can't settle down, he can't find his own rhythm because Jose's just all over the place. Whatever he does, he counters it, he turns him, he off balances him.
He's still pushing forward, give him that, but.
Well, he's there, but he's not actually pushing forward. He's stood in front of him.
Yeah.
But he's not really doing much. For me, the Italian fighter needs to kick and punch. Again, he stood there, he's waiting to get hit, he's waiting for the next reply.
Yeah, he's starting to mark up now as well around the body.
Yeah. Big right elbow coming in, there it is.
Shot there.
Oh, that hurt him. That got him. That
left up to the body. I don't know if he gets up. Oh, yeah. I can see him like not wanting this fight, you know.
No, but Valera's gonna come straight back in for that again.
The body.
Then. Oh, big teep to the face. He's gonna try and pin his man now. His backspinning elbow was on its way.
Oh, great right hand to the body. Oh, and ref stopped it.
Ref stopped it for outclassmen.
His coach is not happy with that decision. But the referee has spoken.
Yeah. I mean, he stopped it for outclassmen. He couldn't have won the fight. He was going backwards. And he would have needed a knockout and he wasn't even landing any strikes. I didn't understand it. Whether I would have called it myself, I'm not sure.
Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for both fighters, please. And at 2 minutes and 53 seconds completed of the third round, your referee, Mr. Jesse Saunders, has stopped the contest, deeming Ivano Sibiero in no position to continue. Therefore, your winner by TKO, fighting out of the red corner, it's the Pitbull, Jose Barrera! And show your appreciation for our other round, Ivano Sibiero! I just want to say thank you everyone for coming out today, coming down here supporting all the fighters. Keep up guys, because you're going to be the next Grand Prix. Don't miss it. It's epic, right? Thank you very much for coming down. Enjoy the show.
Jose Barrera, ladies and gentlemen.